Hello, Zero K fans. This is Shadowfury333 with another quick match practice session. I mean, this is what I tend to do for Skullgirls because replays aren't quite a thing yet. I mean, I don't know how much they're going to be a thing. Hopefully, they are at least good enough that they get included in the final retail. It looks like that's probably the case. I think that the desync bugs are fixed, so then it's probably there. Damn it, Fake Angel, there's never going to be Annie. You don't need to remind everybody. If Fake Angel in chat is trolling everybody, vote Annie. Never. The answer is probably never. I'm sorry. Anyway, Annie aside, of whom we'll not speak again, although we'll probably encounter somebody with the color palettes, because, let's face it, everyone likes the Annie color palettes. They are pretty good color palettes. I don't use them myself, but, eh. Other than that, let's get to the actual main show of me basically embarrassing myself while playing the game. Or, I suppose to put it more charitably, me practicing and sort of doing a training diary thing, which I tend to do most every week, or at least every second week or so. So this is on retail, since I couldn't get anyone for doing beta lobbies. So if it looks a little bit weird, if it looks like some things like, say, Fukua's DHC being extremely useful, or DHC BFFs being extremely useful, which it is in this version and will not be when the final update releases, that's why, because we're on retail, we're not on beta. It's also why there isn't a conspicuous beta printed at the top of the screen. Curiosity. Let's see, first off, Peacock, Beowulf. Ladies and gentlemen, it's not quite anti-team, but honestly, I do find Beowulf a little bit... Oh, I was expecting a Beowulf assist right out of the gate. Ah. Oh, I almost got a fire... Sorry, I almost got a fire blue, and then I screwed up and threw it on my head. Because that's what I do. Give me my head back. Oh, what the heck? This is... getting... I hate when I do this. It's an input error that I keep... Okay, let's get Fuku in here. This is the DHC I've been talking about. BFF DHC... What the? That's not what I was expecting. Ah, that would have been a perfect time for Fiber. Why did I not Fiber? Like, there's a bomb coming at me. I really should Fiber, and I didn't. And there we go, that's the BFF's DHC I was talking about. Oops, what the heck? That's not what I wanted at all. I mean, actually, it would have been a bad reset if it worked, but that wasn't what I wanted. And just, oh, come on. There we go, let's finish off Peacock, and there we go, done. And now take up Beowulf. Yeah, I figured that would happen, but hey, at least... bad time for Heavy Kick. Because I put the hitbox... That Heavy Kick put the hitbox right in the way, and so I got hit! I only got hit because I did the Heavy Kick, and now Fukua is... not dead, but in a bad okay, now she's probably dead. Come on, let's do the... do the zoning style. Oh, come on. Get hit. Ow. Just don't snap back. Oh, he had me, too. I could have been snapbacked. Nope. Fortune's out. Well, best shot I have. What? Oh, wow. Okay, that was way too close. But hey, Fireballs won it. Fireballs won the match. That was embarrassingly close. I'm probably going to encounter them again. Why do I do it that way? Am I going to encounter them again? Is this the same person? I'm a doctor? No. Three much. Not sure who they are. I'm a doctor is a familiar name, but three much? Not so much. Whenever they're ready. So yeah, Beowulf I find really annoying, mostly because of the chair. If you've ever fought a decent Biken player in Guilty Gear in tatami mats, it's basically the same thing, and I have exactly the same problem with that. So it's... I'm kind of used to it, and yet at the same time, still find it annoying. Okay, so they're playing... What the? Got distracted by the assists. That was not what I wanted. Oh shoot, I can't believe I let that drop. That was a double snap opportunity. And I just let it drop like that. Alright, come on. What? Did not want to do down kick, I wanted to do up kick. Right, of course. Their assist would have been safe. Because that is... I found that assist really hard to deal with. What the... Screwed up the inputs. Again. Let's just get you out of there and then switch over. Because I've been doing that surprisingly often. Okay. I didn't have... why did I not check my meter? I should have checked my meter. I should know I don't have the meter to do that right now. Oops. Come on. Why am I putting myself in the corner? What is wrong with me? The corner's a bad place. I don't want to be in the corner. Okay, that's a bit better. Try to put them in the corner. Okay, get Valentine out of the way, and Fukua, of course. Oh, wait, they have a Fukua too? I didn't even notice that. I didn't even check their team first. That was unwise. That was also unwise. I meant to jump first. Would have also not been the best idea, but at least it would have, you know, not been... okay, no, it would have been a bad idea. All around, bad ideas. Punishing their assist, but not punishing their point. This isn't working. Oh, if I get... Oh, that wasn't Valentine. That was Fukua. I was thinking, if I can get Valentine into a double snap situation... Nope, not what I want. There we go. Get rid of double. Switch back to fortune so I don't die. What the... How did that down to forward not work? That was the perfect down to forward opportunity to go for the kill. And I completely threw it away. I can't believe that just happened. I'm gonna lose this match because I screwed up a down to forward input. Most embarrassing thing. I mean, I screw up that input all the time. Part of the reason I'm doing this is to try to... What the... shoot, I thought I'd... What the? I didn't die? That was unexpected. There we go, got rid of the Fukua, and now the double. What? I win by timeout! Okay, that was weird. I don't think it's ever that rarely happens. Like, Skullgirls is not a game that ends by timeout, so that was surprising. I think a combo breaker was two matches I showed that were on stream that ended in timeout. And... each of those was extremely intense, and no one, like, the fact that it went to timeout, no one even noticed, like now with me, that it went to timeout. Like, wait, that's time? That's it? That's all we have? I mean, 3 minutes, but still. Yeah, it was really surprising. Or is it 3 or 5 minutes? I think it's 3 minutes, but I'm not totally sure. So I'm pretty sure that the timer on there, each second on the timer, is a little under 2 seconds in real time. I'm fairly certain that's the timing. But who pays attention to that? Because that's not... Well, now for the DHC. Now for the DHC that still works in this version, or at least doesn't scale as aggressively as it does in beta. Oh, they hit me. What the? How did that not get safe? That was weird. Not what I want. Okay, are they gonna go for a throw reset? Yes, they are. How did I get that reset? Wow. That was not a safe reset. I should not have been able to get that reset, but I got it anyway. The medium kick reset after... like, on the second landing? I keep making that mistake of using medium kick on land. Medium kick is not safe on land. Medium kick does not continue the combo when you land after the heavy kick in the air. I don't know why I keep doing that. Because it doesn't work. But I just keep doing it, because occasionally you get crazy resets like that, which don't make sense, which shouldn't happen. But occasionally that's allowed to happen. Okay, well, I'm guessing they're gonna go for a high block. Oh, that was not what I expected at all. I should have gone for the fiber. Ah, they didn't go for the throw reset. Okay, well, shoot. This is a bad position to be in. Oh, now they go for the throw reset. This is the exact opposite of the last game. The last game was against this person, I'm pretty sure. Were they just letting me beat them so they could download me? I think they were. Which doesn't really make any sense, because they hadn't really seen me play defensively up to that point. I hate being in the corner. I hate being in the corner against Big Band. Like, against anybody in general, but Big Band is so tall that jumping out of the corner feels impossible. Like, I feel like I have to counter hit in order to get out of there, and of course I can't, because it's Big Band, so they're going to have the kick pedal thing that's going to hit me. I hate being in the corner against Big Band. I just can't believe the entire match happened. No, that's too much. The entire match happened because I didn't go for the fiber opening. I got stuck in the corner. Now I guess Reznika and myself are 1-1. Oh, there we go. They're back. Okay. Well, now we can settle this. Tiebreaker. They'll probably win. That last match was not encouraging. But hey, we'll see what happens. I don't know.
Does punching you count as beatboxing?
Okay, let's see. What the? I don't understand where these attacks are coming. Man, it's like they're just mashing buttons and it's working because I keep going for things that wouldn't work. I keep going for the unsafe. Why do I keep going for the unsafe chains? What is wrong with me? Light punch, medium punch, then heavy punch. Not light punch straight to heavy punch. It doesn't work. I mean, at least I can rely on the fact that they're not blocking. Okay, what the heck was that? Silly rollbacks. Okay, well now I can punish them for that. I keep screwing up. Almost. Yes! What?! How the... darn it, the rollbacks are being a real pain. Why are they still doing that? They should know that's not gonna work. Well, whatever. I win by a technicality! I don't have a technicality, it wasn't a timeout, but I barely win. That was embarrassingly close. But I still won. 2-1 against Reznika. Yes, thank you, Fenster, for telling me to do the jumping fireball. Pointing out the jumping fireball for Fukua is the way that she zones. Because Fenster's the one that told me that. Really appreciate that advice, it's been very helpful. Because it won me that match, as you can see right there. If I was on the ground, if I was doing what I normally do, which is a grounded heavy fireball, I would have lost that match. I would have been killed by Giant Step. That would have taken me out completely. But instead, I was able to zone out and win. Or at least win from range. Solo Filia. Ooh. I gotta... What? I didn't get out in time. That's surprising. That was... Really? Okay, that's Filia for you. What the? I guess go with a simple DHC. I still haven't got the Fire Blues reliable enough that I want to do that, so let's go for this. Simple DHC. What the? Ah! Again with the crouching. There we go, throw reset. Ah, well, punish something, I guess. What? Thought you could punish me for throwing out my assist. Well, you can punish me for that, but that's not the assist throw. Because throwing out my assist means I make you hit buttons that lets me hit you while you're not blocking. Like so. There we go. I play Fukua because I... Okay, I play Fortune better than I play Fukua, but... I play Fukua because I like her moveset. I like the fact that I have a large range of options. Both close and... Oops, I didn't want to decline. Both close range and long range. Mostly the thing that made me like her was the shadows, even though I don't use them that often. But I just like the fact that I have zoning options and I have rushdown options, and I can do both. I mean, if you have tips for how to play Fukua better, please let me know. Like, I've got a lot to learn. Darn, I didn't want to decline that 120 ping match. That was a mistake. That was an input error. Oh, come on! Why is it not giving me low ping matches? It's only 7. Sheesh, anywhere these people are playing is probably in the middle of the afternoon or... There we go, finally. Someone local. In the middle of the afternoon, in the middle of the night.
Looks like I found a new scratching post.
Quiet on the set! Let's rock!
Oh darn, I didn't want to do that. I wanted to go for the fiber loop again. I didn't look at my meter first, that was a mistake. Okay, that was a mistake that I... Let's just go over to level 3. It's one thing I kind of like, I didn't actually know until Combo Breaker, was that if you do a level 3 as a DHC, you can do it with only 2 bars a meter. If you had 3 bars when you started the chain of supers... Actually, I think it's how it works. For duos, at least, it effectively works that way. If you had 3 bars when you started the chain of supers, you can do a level 3 on the incoming DHC. Oh, come on, what the heck? Nope, that was bad. Wow. That doesn't usually happen. Normally, Fukua is my savior. If the match is going south, Fukua usually wins it for me. But apparently, Fortune's going to be the one to do so.
I'm a rescue.
It's in the can.
A 3-then-1? What are you talking about? Oh, yeah, 3-then-1. Okay, yeah, so you're... Talking about the DHCs. Yeah, I don't know if trios can do it. I'm guessing they can if you have 3 bars and then you do DHCs. I'm pretty sure level 3 can finish it. So you do level 1, level 1, level 3. I think that's possible. But I don't play a trio. Oh, okay. So Highlake is going to play against me. Alright, so... Cool. Okay, I'll set up a lobby after this match. Because I've already started the match. So let's... Yeah. So give me a couple minutes. I'll set that up and then I can play against Highlake, who has been... Basically telling me not to play Fukua, although apparently that's because they used to and didn't like her or find her as fun. I personally find her to be quite interesting and flexible, but to each their own. That's why there's more than one character. Oh, Squigly. I should have noticed that. This is interesting. Well, let's go back to the DHC. There we go, that's what I want. What the? Not what I wanted at all. Darn it, I got... This is the annoying part about finding Parasoul. Parasoul is really good at the mix-up. Okay, Squigly is a pain in the butt. Major pain in the butt. How did I not... How did I not tech off that? Okay, that was actually me trying to push block. Oh, great! Wow, I can't believe my Fukua has gotten that much worse than my Fortune. I mean, I realize I've been mainly practicing Fortune just because I, like, Fortune just has so many more things you need to practice. Like that, well, okay, that I didn't even do right. But yes, that would have been the thing to practice because that was allowing me to get, oh, come on. Okay, well, I should probably adjust who I consider my anti-team to be because Squigly needs to be on it. I cannot deal with, I have a really hard time dealing with Squigly. Okay, well, now let's go fight Highlake. So, I guess... Well, I'm currently in retail. I mean, I can switch over to beta if you prefer, but I am currently in retail. It's not a big deal to switch. So I kind of... Actually, I'd rather switch. I prefer to play in beta. So I'm just going to do exactly that. Because I prefer beta. Oh. Well, it's too late. I've already started switching. Alright, let's get into beta. Because beta is the final. Beta is final. Beta is effectively going to be what ultimately is the is Skullgirls. Wait, whoops. See, everything beta has is Skullgirls. So what you see is final. There are no further updates after this point. Just to make it absolutely clear. Oops. Alright, let's get back to the game. I am ready. Okay, so let's see how Highlake plays. I'm curious. I do prefer doing lobby play. I do want to see how this works. I mean, how Highlake plays, because I do play lobbies fairly often. I know how they work. It's just... Oh hey, an Annie color palette. How about that? I don't know if that's just because they prefer that palette, or if they're referencing the very first comment that showed up. Mind you, that showed up on Hitbox and they were watching on Twitch, so I don't think they saw it. Okay, Parasoul and Fukua. Interesting. So they're gonna show me, I guess, how to play Fukua. Why did I go backwards? Why did I do that? Again, with the pressing buttons. Try blocking first, and then punish when... Ah, that was a heavy attack that would have been perfect punishing. That was another heavy attack that would have been perfect punishing, except Napalm Pillar came up. What the? Oh, crap. Well, I probably lost, because I think that's a double snap. Yep, that's a double snap. What? Nope, that's a double snap. Wow. Nope. Okay, well, this is an embarrassing start. Why did I jump into that? I'm doing everything wrong. I'm doing absolutely everything wrong. Okay, let's try it again. Let's... didn't even get to see their Fukua. Okay, well, there we go. Problem solved. I get to see their Fukua entirely. Exclusively. Well, they're probably going to step back... Oh, whoa, I did not expect that. Oops, don't want to do that at all. I wanted to do this so I could do the GHC. There we go. Darn it. Darn it, that's what I wanted. I'm screwing my inputs. I've been trying to do a simpler version of my typical combo, and I normally get it right, but I'm getting distracted by myself. Yeah, I'm distracting myself by speaking, but that's part of this, what I'm doing here. Oh, I almost got a burst bait off that. What? Oh, crap. You gotta be kidding me. What the? That? I was in the air, so what was I supposed to do against that? I can't block low in the air. Sounds like my game to have too.
Let's have another. Looks like a
okay. So,
gentlemen and ladies, it's showtime.
Darn it, why are my inputs not working? Oh right, push blocking, of course. Yeah, I can't do that fiber loop to save my life. Literally, I can't do it to save my life. As you can clearly see, I cannot do it to save my character's life. I don't know why. I don't know why it's so hard. For some reason, that second heavy punch just never comes through. Ever. In a real fight. It comes through in training, but never comes through in a real fight. And thus I lose. I need to get good at that, because that's the only valid combo for Fortune. Everything else is just not good enough. There's no other combo that's good enough for Fortune.
Believe in the announcer that believes in you.
I know how, like, I don't see what you mean about Fukua. I still like Fukua. I just need to learn a bit more of her setups, that's all. I don't know if this is what this community's problem with Fukua has been. Oh right, that's a Darn it, why'd I do that? I never want to throw up my head. Throwing out the head is always a bad idea, and I'm just getting distracted by having to defend my choice of character against someone who's beating me and is therefore more valid as a person than I am. What? I thought that would work. Ah, come on. Are they gonna try doing their level 3 on me, or what? It didn't work when I wanted it to! My inputs never... Yeah, there was a level 3. Why do my inputs never work? Well, at least they never worked perfectly. Be low block.
Was that good?
I don't know why I have such a problem with this thing. Okay, solo Parasoul now. But yeah, I don't know why it is that I keep screwing up all the time.
Gentlemen and ladies,
like, I'm using this for almost a year now. You think I'd be good enough at it by now? Just one single input device. I'll switch over characters. See if I can make this work. No, not again! Not the down heavy punch, the heavy punch, the normal heavy punch. Like that. And I want to do light first. Damn it. Not what I wanted at all. I keep doing this wrong. I just want to get that combo in so I can make up for having screwed up. Like, whenever I screw up a combo, I'm screwed for the rest of the match because my entire focus is, for the rest of the match, on trying to make up for having screwed up. Because I can't forgive myself because I screwed up. And that's just unforgivable. Great. See what I mean? I was so focused on getting that Fukua combo working again because I screwed it up. I can't focus on anything else. But I don't know how to get out of it. I'm just stuck in that mindset. I'd like to relax, but I can't. I'm very bad at relaxing. Relaxing is not a thing I can do. Right, defense. Got it. Mix up defense. Okay, Highlake's give me a bit of advice on mixing up defense and relaxing. I can't relax, but I can mix up. I can probably do mix up. That's gonna take a while to detonate. Don't have to worry about her if she's not on the ground. If she's on the ground, then I need to worry about it. Because if she's on the ground, she can detonate at will. If she's not on the ground, then I'm good. And let's try to get this right this time. No. Not. Why did I even call an assist? I didn't hit the assist button. Well, okay, I realize it's not a button, it's a combination, but it keeps coming out whenever I don't want it. Like, I kind of wish I could disable the combinations for assists and just have macros, and basically just have a dedicated assist button. Because that would... Crap. Oh, that was handy. Oops. Darn it. No, what? I thought she wasn't blocking. That was the start of an attack, wasn't it? I thought that was the start of an attack.
You fought well. Let's get a round of applause for our contestants.
Like, I don't know what to do. I keep starting off strong and then just completely falling apart. Every single time. The fact that I can't do the fiber loop doesn't help any. Okay, apparently you can do the heavy kick off that, but I've never been able to. How the heck are you so fast? Oh right, Fortune has light attacks. I don't know why, but I can't get into my head to use her light moves, probably because they're not as strong as their heavies. And it's like, once I get into a combo, who cares? Might as well use the strongest move, right? Get up to something safe. Why do I always use the heavies? Actually, wait, I know why. Because I'm not good at hit confirm, and so I figure I need to get the heavy move in, so I either the heavy move in, unless I know the combo to start with the light. Because my hit confirm isn't very good. So yeah, most of my style at this point is basically making up for the fact that I can't play very well. Because, I don't know, I just haven't had much chance to practice. Gotta be honest, this is still the first fighting game I've really played competitively. And I guess there's a lot of stuff that has to be learned that can't be learned in a year and a half or so. Got crossed up. Shit. I can get in on that. I could have gotten in on that. I could have done a crouching light punch or light kick. Wow, I go from doing really well against a bunch of people in Quickmatch now to just being 7-0. Yeah, it was my first 2D fighter, and I've only played for like a year and a half. Well, not my first 2D fighter, it's my first that I've played. I've played other 2D fighters, but this is the first one I've really focused on getting good at. But I just don't never know what to practice. Or there's so many things to practice, I don't know what to prioritize.
Just one more!
Okay, Highlake saying the game is 90% defense. Well, that explains why I'm bad at it, because it's only been Skullgirls in the last few months that I've even started to learn to block. Because, well, because AI and Guilty Gear, that's why. Because Guilty Gear's AI is basically beaten by frame traps. And so you learn to frame trap perfect. Oh, come on! How did that not hit? Still understand how it was so fast! I just don't understand what to do. Like, I can't. I'm constantly thinking about the next thing I gotta do, because I have to think. Don't tell me not to think, I have to think. That's how I work. I can't work unconsciously, I can't work on reaction. Unless that reaction's been really well trained, I suppose, but otherwise, no. I think about things, that's how I work. That was terribly embarrassing. I'm doing worse progressively. Well, I have to think. That's the only way I work. I don't trust myself enough to not think.
Let's have another. Curiosity can't kill me.
Man, hopefully I can actually get a win off this person.
Gentlemen and ladies, it's showtime.
That was weird. I'm just not sure what to do at any point. How's that? After all this time, I still haven't gotten back used to the fact that there are 6 buttons. I really haven't. I'm not. Like, every other fighter I play is somewhere between 3 and 5. Or have played. So I've typically compensated by simply trying to. Why did I throw my head off? I did not want to throw my head off! Why can't there be a Fortune without throwing your head off? Like, exactly the same kit, except just the head-on part. Because I don't care for the head-off part. I don't need the head-off part. That was supposed to be a super. This game would just listen to my inputs. Or my hands will listen to my brain, one of the two. The only assist I know with Fukua involve an assist. How did that miss? Oh wait, I didn't want to go into the corner. Wait, what the? Why didn't it work? I did the super input and it doesn't work. This is getting really annoying. Like, there's one thing that makes me annoyed to the point of being unable to relax at all, I just enraged, it is input errors. Anytime I screw up my inputs, like, there's nothing that pisses me off more than screwed up inputs. Absolutely nothing when playing a game pisses me off more than trying to do something and not having that thing happen. Trading lobby, come on, I need to beat you! I've been so close. In the first few matches, I was so close. I have honor to redeem. I've embarrassed myself so much as it is. Fine. Do a bloody training lobby. I don't think you can go over there from change characters, though. I think you have to go straight to return to lobby. So I can't believe how close I was. I just input. Screwing up my inputs has been all that's been breaking me. Screw it, let's do the DHC. Ah, no. What the? Oh, I didn't have the super forward, that's why. Still? Okay, well.
We'll be right back after these
matches. Highlake beats themselves, I guess. Okay, I guess now we can make it. I don't think you can make it a training lobby without quitting and creating new. Okay, there we go. Fine, training lobby. I can't believe it took me that long to get a win against an off character. The best thing when you're fighting Peacock is if that bomb gets dropped and they aren't trying to force you into it, well, stay away from it. Best case scenario is what just happened. They get blown up by their own bomb. And that's exactly what happened. Are they gonna come or what? I have a lobby open. You may enter at any time. What the? Okay, never mind. 0K is getting in the way of me inviting to lobby because that always happens. I should stop being summer. I hate summer. I like spring, but I hate summer. It's too warm. Okay, there we go. So now, training lobby. This is gonna be really hard to put in the description. I don't really want to make multiple videos just because it's... As it is, getting a lot of views is hard with more than one video. But the description is going to be pretty weird. It's going to have basically three different things.
Gentlemen and ladies,
okay, so I'm not sure where we're practicing, but... not what I wanted. What forward? Heavy punch, air dash, heavy punch. Why is it so hard for my fingers to do that? It's not like I have any sort of finger muscle issues or anything like that. I just seem to keep screwing up the timings. Okay, well, that was half of what I wanted. Actually, two-thirds of what I wanted. Not the correct two-thirds. What the? No, light... it's light kick, heavy punch. And that's the combo. It's a very specific combo. You have to do it to be, as far as I can tell, considered a decent fortune player. Like, it's just part of being a fortune player is doing that particular combo. It's like the same way you can't be a proper Zerg player in Brood War if you don't know how to do Muta Micro. You have to be, as far as I can tell, able to do this combo if you're going to be considered a fortune player. And in case you're wondering, yes, I did play Zerg in Brood War, and yes, I did learn to Muta Micro, and no, I haven't played it in a while, so don't ask me to try to demonstrate it on stream anytime soon. Oh, come on, not what I wanted. Why does my head keep popping up? I need my head on, if you'd be so kind. I can't fight without a head. There we go. If it weren't the fact that I can't get my fire bloop on to save my life, like that, I hit the heavy punch button. It seems to have registered as part of the dash. Why is that part of the dash? It's not. The dash is the two. Is the light and medium? I'm hitting light and medium. Why does the heavy get ignored as a result of that? Again! All the time! There we go, finally get that part! This is getting really annoying. Oh, darn it, I almost had it, too. I got most of it, at least. See, I can do the fire blip occasionally on stream. Am I light punch neutral? Really? That's useful? Huh. Okay. Okay, well, no one had actually... I don't recall anyone telling me specifically to do that, so I assumed that it wasn't a thing to do compared to light kick. Like, most of the combo guides I've seen involved light kick as a starter, or crouching light kick. Oh, I need to do all three. Right, crap. When my combo ends? When which combo ends? The Fukua portion? Because normally when the combo ends, I'm not trying to go for recess there. I'm still trying to get the loop on reliably so I can actually do it. Oh, that's why you don't want to do... Interesting. Oh, but that's... That combos? Nope. Did not get the light kick. What the hell? Oh, okay. So they're saying I need to reposition when I combo, or finish a combo. Ah, I don't know what... Ah, I don't know if Fortress Double Snap! Darn it! I just gotta... I thought the heavy punch, or crouching heavy punch would send Parasoul higher. I was holding defense there. I was blocking. That doesn't work. Right, I gotta remember, it's the second one, light kick to heavy punch. Even if I haven't done one yet. It's the second chain in the combo, do it that way. Crap. Okay, well, this... Maybe I'll stick the training stuff into its own video. Or training mode stuff into its own video. I don't know. What the? I don't know how this is being allowed, but okay. That was weird. Oh. Hey, drone. Oh, right, I guess I'm too used to doing throw. Why don't I have chat moderators to kick drone out whenever he's here? I'm half joking, by the way. And I don't play Street Fighter because the game's too slow for me. I like air dashers. I've always just pretty much played air dashers. Street Fighter's not fast enough. That's what I say. There we go, got my head back. And I'm half joking because I know that drone's half joking. And for those of you watching on Twitch, it's Mighty Sheep I'm talking about. They go by drone and 0K. So, yeah. Which, for those of you who don't know, that's the main game that I cast. Oh, that's... I didn't even think I could do that. Oh, right, I can't go from there into... I learned the hard way. I cannot go from the Rekka into the double snap. Oh, or just do an alpha counter. That works, too. Not what I wanted. And yes, I realized that I was gone from... going from not... from talking shit about Street Fighter to using Street Fighter terminology because the entire Skullgirls community uses Street Fighter terminology as a matter of course. I don't think most people in the competitive community even offhand know what the Skullgirls official terminology for a lot of this stuff is. Ah, crap. How'd that work? Wait, the wiki doesn't even use Skullgirls terminology? Wow. Okay, apparently Highlake's pointed that out. I'm not sure if they're talking about... They're talking about the Shoryuken wiki, because that's the only one I know of offhand. I know there isn't a Dustloop wiki, and I don't think there's a Mizumi wiki, so... Okay. Highlake's apparently done, which is actually a good timing, because it's been almost an hour. I should probably close up the stream. Wait. What are you wanting to do, Highlake? I don't know what you're trying to do here. But... I don't know, I guess play again? Because, I mean, I'm good to finish. I don't know if they're planning on showing one specific thing. Oh, demoing fortune stuff. Okay. demoing how light punch is actually the most powerful thing that she has, because apparently that's the case, and I did not realize that. I wonder if that's true of Fukua. It probably is. I see. Demonstrating the neutral game.
Looks like I found a new scratching post.
Gentlemen and ladies, what can I learn? Oh wow, that is powerful. Darn it, that's... I can fiber off that. Ah, I can't believe I screwed up the input on that. Oops. Okay, counter hits for everyone. Ah, I did not want to throw my head. Okay, yeah, didn't want to throw my head up. That was bad. But stay near my head. Stay near my head. Ah, I almost got you bit. Come on. Oh. Darn it. Well, I got my head back at least. Darn it. Once again, I'm screwing up the fiber loop part. Oh, that was punishable, if nothing. If nothing, that was punishable. Okay, I need to use heavy on that one, not light. Or maybe medium. Ah, shoot. Let the inputs wait too long. Hmm. Ah, of course I screwed up. Well, it feels like the game is slowing down slightly whenever I do that. Oh, that was an interesting reset opportunity. Or cross-up opportunity, I guess. Of course I screwed that up. Why'd I go for the fiber? That's unsafe. Again. Finally, I get that part. Nope. I wonder what the paration is, actually. I thought I'd double check that. Here's what the paration is if you use the light punch or crouching light punch as the opener. Because I'm used to Guilty Gear, where basically everything that is an easy opener has like somewhere between 70 and 80% paration. That is to say, everything gets its damage reduced by 70 to 80% in the entire combo because you started with the easy move. I'm curious what happens to Skullgirls. I don't think it does. I think Skullgirls is pretty straightforward damage calculations, so... Ah! Again with the thing where it doesn't work because I'm bad at that move. And of course the DHCM too used to doing. What did that miss? That was weird. That combo seems weird. I wonder if the properties of the hitbox would change at all. That or just because I'm trying to go for the more efficient version, it's not as reliable. Oh, that's actually, I should be doing crouching medium kick, not standing medium kick doesn't work. Wow, that was a tech opportunity. Darn it. I didn't think I'd be given that tech opportunity. Oh, whoops. I have my stick get stuck like that. That was a perfect opportunity to do that combo I was trying to do. Darn it. Why am I not doing the setups? Okay, I haven't practiced Fukua anywhere near as much as Fortune, so that's probably why I'm screwing it. Ah, darn it. Not that. What? No, it's not what it is at all. It's this, and then you do the shatter. It's crouching. That's actually the one time where you want to use crouching heavy punch, is that particular setup. Come on. I'm not really meant to get out of the air, but whatever. Yes, of course. It's crouching medium kick. Crouching medium kick. But the one time I want to be crouching to do an attack, and I don't. What was I thinking? Forward heavy punch does not do something different from regular heavy punch. Oh, wait, that was... Okay, master the neutral and I'll be happy. That's what Highlake is saying. Well, that's actually pretty solid advice. I totally understand that advice. Which is one of the reasons I have been practicing a lot more away from training mode, just because you can't easily learn neutral in training mode. Whoa, that was not what I expected at all, but okay, I'll go with that. Not the best thing I want to do! Yeah, I needed to block. That was my only hope. There was no resetting after that. Although PBGC Light Punch is actually really handy. As is a PBGC Super. PBGC Supers are typically handy. I keep forgetting PBGC exists because that's like... That is the counter to block string. You can't block string for free in Skullgirls. Your opponent has the opportunity when they're in a block string to punish your carelessness. Like so. That's a good example of it. Or if I were to start blocking, which I might, I don't know. Okay, no I'm not, because I don't have to. Because I'm able to switch, because I'm able to get that hit in. But yeah, block strings are not free in Skullgirls, which has been one of the weirdest things to get used to, because pretty much every other air dasher, block strings are both free and kind of the basis of the neutral. But because of push blocking, that's not the case in Skullgirls, and honestly, I like that. I'm still getting used to it as a concept. I thought I'd be able to nail it. Okay, well. That probably might have been the best idea, but... What the? Oh, that... How did that cause the slide? I didn't get this. Got the second one, didn't get the... It's like, it's always something. Either I miss the second heavy punch, or I miss the Elgato. It's one of the... It's some part of the combo I always screw up. Or the first heavy punch. Although, it's actually a classic mistake, because I do the air dash too early. And that's where push blocking comes in. Okay, so I think I'm just gonna call it here. So, thanks Highlake for the help and tips and training mode stuff. And thank you all for watching, and this is gonna be it for this session of my practicing. So, I hope you enjoyed that, and have a good night, everyone.